Europe's forests are suffering, and how many of their trees will survive this year's heat wave remains to be seen. Why? Because most European woodlands are not ready for a planet that is heating up. A study published recently in the magazine Nature makes the problem clear. A severe drought in 2018 and 19 put Europe's forests and agricultural lands under serious strain. Now the consequences of those record-breaking summers are becoming fully apparent. While vegetation quickly bounced back from a similar dry spell in 2003, European forests aren't recovering fast enough this time. Take Germany, where research has shown that almost 97% of the forests might not be equipped to survive climate change. That same study in Nature shows that extreme droughts are also expected to become more frequent in Europe in the coming decades, further affecting soil fertility and biodiversity. But there's still hope. If one looks closer, a pattern emerges. The trees that died in Germany last summer were largely in non-native plantations. Most of the country's natural forests did survive the drought. But what does that mean? To save our forest, we need to drastically change our approach to forestry.
In der jetzigen Situation wird viel diskutiert, was passiert mit unseren Wäldern. Werden sie uns abhanden kommen? Also da muss man vielleicht ein bisschen unterscheiden und sagen, die Forsten, also der Begriff des künstlich gestalteten und erhaltenen Waldes, der wird das nicht schaffen, solchen Klimawandel, der uns bevorsteht und schon da ist, zu überwinden, weil er keine organische, systemische Anpassungsfähigkeit hat.
In traditional forestry, trees are seen as a source of wood and paper. To keep up with production, forests are sometimes planted, maintained, and harvested into monocultures of only one or two tree species. Decades of this kind of management have robbed many forests of their natural ability to adapt to climate change. So, to protect our forests, we need to see them for what they are.
Wir müssen auch viel stärker den Wald als Ökosystem und uns Menschen auch als Teil von Natur betrachten, weil wir sind ja unter anderem in dieser globalen Krise von Klimakrise, von Biodiversitätskrise, also von einem Massenartensterben, weil wir den Planeten so ein bisschen als unser Warenlager betrachten.
Es sind ja sehr handfeste ökologische Funktionen, die die Wälder haben, oftmals in größerem Umfang als andere Ökosysteme. Und entsprechend sind die Wälder besonders bedeutsam für den Landschaftswasserhaushalt, für das Mikro-, Meso-, auch Makroklima, wie man sagen kann, also über alle Ebenen hinweg.
While studies show that forest coverage in Europe has actually increased over the past decade, the reality is that most of this consists of monocultures, full of non-native species. From 2016 to 2018 alone, harvested forest areas across Europe increased in size by 34% over previous years, further reducing biodiversity on an already highly urbanized continent.
Wenn bestimmte Prozesse ausfallen, wie zum Beispiel Kühlung oder klar bestimmte Störungen zu stark ausfallen, wie einfach Temperaturen, die viel zu hoch werden, kann das natürlich lokal, regional dazu führen, dass vor allem dann langlebige Organismen, die schon gewisse stabile Umweltbedingungen brauchen, wie Bäume, keine guten Bedingungen mehr haben zu existieren. Und um es konkret zu sagen, wenn wir es zu weit treiben mit dem Klimawandel, können wir uns vorstellen, dass auch in Deutschland und Europa, in weiteren Regionen, Wald es immer schwerer haben wird.
But there are alternative, more natural approaches to forest management. For over 20 years, Lutz Faeser has been leading the way in the Lübeck forest in northeastern Germany. He is hoping to prove that a paradigm shift in forestry is also possible in practice.
Wir wollen sozusagen in der Größenordnung von 80% der Entwicklung des Vorrates, des Reichtums dieses Waldes zulassen. Das soll sich entwickeln bis dahin. Und die restlichen 20%, also auch des Vorrates, die entnehmen wir. Also da sagen wir, gut, das ist eine kleine Wunde, aber wir wollen sie so entnehmen, dass du das gar nicht merkst, Wald. Nicht? Du bist primär immer noch selbst organisiert.
In the so-called Lübeck model, harvesting activities are very limited. And to protect important organisms in the soil, no pesticides are used. The Lübeck Forest is home to a diverse mix of tree species. And in contrast to traditional forestry practices, dead trees are not cleared away. Instead, they're left standing or lying to assist in the regeneration of the forest. Their first function is to continue providing shade, but they do so much more. Their organic matter helps the forest soil absorb more water, something missing on the neatly cleared floors of plantation forests. These dead trees also provide hiding places and homes to animals, who bring with them seeds from other parts of the forest. And their added organic matter also helps the forest restore itself. As they decompose, their leaves and branches gradually add nutrients to the soil, which other plants and trees need to thrive.
Wir reden in Zukunft nicht mehr über Strukturen. Der Wald muss genau so aussehen und in dem und dem Alter diese Konfiguration haben, sondern wir reden nur noch über Bedingungen, sich optimal anpassen zu können. Die Waldbausysteme der Zukunft sind Anpassungssysteme.
So, to save our forest, we need to push for a change of mindset. Forests are not just the sum of the paper and lumber and other products that they produce, but are complex ecosystems. Home to a beautiful web of plants and animals, including ourselves, and we need to treat them as such. Here's how you can start helping. Learn more about natural approaches to forestry, like the Lübeck model. Take time to learn about your country's forestry practices, then vote for politicians who treat forests as ecosystems. Consume less wood and paper, and recycle as much as you can. And share this video to spread the knowledge.